Few things are quite as tragic as two people who find that they do love each other, but the physical side is completely wrong. And this, our tune, is one such all-too-human story. It begins at a party more than 30 years ago, when Lee first claps eyes on Kenny.
I've never seen anybody as thin and white. This stick insect on the floor, which turned out to be my future husband, and if you'd have told me I was going to marry that stick insect, I would have been... I'd have thought that was hilarious.
The two struck up an immediate friendship. They shared the same sense of humour, and very soon they became inseparable. But Lee never imagined for a moment that her new friend was anything but gay.
I had a lot of gay friends, and I just thought he was naturally a gay friend, and that's what he became. He became my gay friend.
I'd like to come inside.
Kenny was tortured about his sexuality. He was attracted to men, but his Catholic upbringing told him it was a mortal sin. Behind the clowning in public, of course, he was deeply miserable about, as he felt it, appearing skinny and unattractive, and fancying blokes.
Oh, but doctor, these aren't my shoulders.
That's all right, I'm not a doctor.
He wanted desperately to be normal and what he called normal. But of course, he couldn't ever been normal because he wasn't normal even if he'd have been normal.
As Lee and Kenny drew closer, the inevitable happened.
It started to become very intense. And one night it just happened, it occurred. And the next morning he was on the phone telling everybody.
Kenny thought a miracle had happened. And perhaps in those druggy 60s days, it seemed like anything was possible. So Lee and Kenny decided to marry. And for a while, everything was blissful.
Did the earth move for you, darling?
Well, so-so.
Well, let's try again.
Okay.
But the cracks in the relationship soon began to reappear. There was no miracle. There had been no cure. Kenny was married to Lee, but his desire was elsewhere.
He was seeing Burt Lancaster, as he used to say. Not me, you know, at night.
Although Lee and Kenny still loved one another, their marriage had become a lie. At parties, Kenny would dance with gay men, while Lee wished the floor would swallow her up. Eventually, Lee could take no more.
That was the time when I sat down and said to him, Ev, I want you to be honest with yourself. Find yourself someone. I'll stick with you until you find yourself someone. But I want the end of this marriage.
Oh, Geoffrey, I'm so sorry. It must be hell for you. But there's no turning back. The decision has been made. But if it doesn't work out, don't come running back to me.
No one knows what would have happened if Lee hadn't, as she says it, pushed him out of the closet. Though today, Lee feels that Kenny's freedom became comedy's loss.
He would put all his angst and his frustrations into his studio, into his work. It all went into his work, and that's how he kept alive, really.
Let's call the whole thing off!
I'd pushed him out. I'd pushed him to accept his sexuality. I'd actually been in a restaurant, and he'd said to me, that waiter's lovely. So I asked the waiter to come out with us.
Kenny and that waiter were to move in together. Lee, with Kenny's acceptance, was seeing another man, an actor from the television series called The Sweeney. But it was when Kenny became friends with a promiscuous Russian called Nikolai that a chill ran through Lee's blood.
I used to call him Old Nick because I always said he'd be the end of Ev, and of course, he was.
Nikolai was HIV positive. And when eventually Kenny was diagnosed with the same condition, that was when Lee began mourning. She never, though, got a chance to say goodbye, because by the time Kenny died in 1995, the two hadn't spoken for several years. Lee was left with her pain and with the memories brought back by a song.
It's what he courted me to. When I said that our relationship changed cogs, it changed gear, that was the tune that was playing at that time, Mama Cass, Dream a Little Dream. And I suppose that was our dream. We wanted to be a perfect couple.
Stars shining bright above you. Night breezes seem to whisper, I love you.
A lot of water has passed under the bridge since then, and today Lee is still with that actor, a great guy called John. They married in 1985. Kenny was the best man at the wedding.
I love my husband now to death. I mean, he's just the perfect husband as far as I'm concerned. But Ev was completely and utterly unique. Why?